Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So today in my this particular video, I am going to discuss about a very interesting concept related to application of Laplacian of Gaussian filter. Okay, that is, apart from edge detection, this LOG filter can be also used for blob detection or binary large object detection. Okay, now let us try to understand how it is possible. So before going ahead, I request you to have a clear understanding about this LOG filter, that what is the theoretical intuition, what is the mathematical intuition, what is the MATLAB implementation. Regarding all this, you should have a clear idea before going ahead. Okay, so if you have, well and good. If you don't know this particular filter, please go through the link given in the description box, because I have already discussed in detail about this particular filter in my previous video. Okay, so that prerequisite you must have to understand the application of LOG as a blob detector. Okay, so now before going further with the blob detection using LOG, let me give you a quick recap on cross correlation. So as you know, cross correlation is nothing but basically we use to find out the similarity between two different signals. Okay, right? Like in image processing domain, a very popular application or use case of cross correlation technique is finding the patterns. Okay, suppose I am having a small pattern and I am having a very big image. Okay, now in the very big image, where or in which locations this particular small pattern is appearing, to get that idea, what we do, we basically do cross correlation in between these two. Okay, that is the small image and this particular bigger image, and in the output we will be getting maximum value or bright pixels where the pattern will be matched, and minimum values where the pattern won't be matching. Okay, that is, minimum values we will be getting at those locations where basically reverse of this particular pattern is present. We are trying to find out some pattern and completely opposite of that pattern is present somewhere in the image. In those locations, as there the pattern and that particular location of the bigger image is not at all matching, that time in those locations we will be getting minimum response, and where exact match will be coming, there we will be getting maximum response, right? So now the problem is, we need to find out what small pattern we need to search in a bigger image to detect the blobs. Okay, that is, what should be the pattern for blob detection. Because if we able to understand that, the process will be very simple. We just apply cross correlation with that pattern with any image and we can detect the location where blobs are appearing, right? So now we need to find out how the pattern will look for a blob or binary large object. There may be mostly two kinds of pattern. One pattern for blob might be having this shape, that is completely dark at the center, and surrounding this dark center, there will be a white ring, that is bright pixels will be surrounding that, and then near to that surrounding is basically gray color pixels will be present. Okay, so this can be taking shape of a blob. I hope you can understand. Now this one, if we apply on a bigger image, what will happen? If this particular small pattern we try to find out in a bigger image, that time in the output we will be getting maximum response when the pattern will be matching. That is, we will be getting maximum response in those locations of the bigger image where in the bigger image there are dark blob on light background. That means this pattern is matching, that's why we will be getting maximum response in the output. And when we will be getting minimum response, that is completely reverse of this particular pattern. Maybe suppose in the bigger image somewhere we are having a region which is basically very bright, and surrounding that there is a dark ring, and surrounding that there are gray colored pixels are present, that time we will be getting minimum response. Okay, that is light blob on dark background. Okay, I hope it is quite clear, right? So this can be one possible pattern which we should find using cross correlation technique in a bigger image to find out the binary large objects. Another pattern can be reverse one. That is, suppose we want to find out a blob which are basically bright. Okay, that time we can use this one. Very simple. That is, this particular pattern, if we try to find in a bigger image using cross correlation, we will be getting maximum response where in the bigger image there is presence of bright or white color or light colored blob on dark background, and we will be getting minimum response where in the bigger image dark blobs are present with light background. That is reverse of this particular pattern. That's what I want to say, right? So I hope now the pattern which we should find in a bigger image, this one is clear to you. So what we can do, we need to generate this kind of pattern, okay, and then we can apply cross correlation on any image and we can detect blobs. Now till now I have not discussed how this blob detection is related to Laplacian of Gaussian, right? Let me discuss that. So like for application wise, I can say, suppose this particular pattern which I have discussed, this one, okay, so this one can be very useful in the blob detection, where the blob detection use case is, suppose I need to count how many sunflowers are there in a big region, okay. So what we'll do, we will simply convert this color image into grayscale image. We will try to apply cross correlation with that grayscale version of this image and this particular pattern. And you can see sunflower centers are dark, okay, and surrounding that light. So we will be getting maximum response wherever this pattern will be matching. That is dark center, light surrounding that there are light pixels, right? So basically this kind of detection using cross correlation, we can get maximum values we will be getting here as pattern will be matching. And we can then count easily, we can say that from that count that how many sunflowers are there in a garden, right? So this can be a very useful use case of blob detection. Now we need to understand how we can create this pattern, okay? So for that I have written a small piece of code which I am going to show you soon. So the code looks like this: CLC clear all close all warning off, okay. Here what I am doing, I am creating one 2D grid, and here I am basically creating Gaussian filter, normal Gaussian filter, okay, 2D Gaussian filter or Gaussian signal. Then this is nothing but what? This is nothing but our Laplacian, right? That is normal Laplacian filter, okay. So this one we can do convolution with Gaussian, that is double derivative of Gaussian we will be getting, which is nothing but Laplacian of Gaussian filter, right? So then we will try to see how the contour of Laplacian of Gaussian will look like. So for that we can use P color and we can draw the contour. Let's check that first, okay. So here let me go to here, continue working, and the same code I have kept here. Let me just do Ctrl A and evaluate selection, okay. So basically I am first creating one Gaussian signal, taking double derivative. That particular shape is nothing but for Laplacian of Gaussian. That contour of Laplacian of Gaussian we will try to find out, okay. So see how that contour looks like. So this is our 2D Gaussian signal. If we take double derivative of Gaussian signal looks like this. This is nothing but our Laplacian of Gaussian kernel, right? So if we check the top view, it will look like this, okay. And what this is indicating, that center part, the intensity is very less, okay. Then it is going hill type of thing, and then again it is becoming plain land, okay. So if you take grayscale representation, you will be getting like this. That is dark color at the center, surrounding that there is basically bright pixels, and surrounding that there are gray color pixels are there. And this is nothing but what? This is nothing but here what I just now discussed, right? That is this one, this particular pattern. So we achieved this particular pattern. So now I hope you can understand what is the relationship in between Laplacian of Gaussian and blob detection. Basically the Laplacian of Gaussian filter is generating this kind of pattern. Now this particular pattern we can do cross correlation with our original image to detect such patterns, that is such blobs, that is those blobs which are dark color, surrounding that there are presence of bright pixels, okay. And there is another name for this particular filter, that is blob filter, because this can be used for finding blobs, okay. Another pattern you might see, that this is looking like eye, okay. So this is also called eye filter, okay. So this particular eye filter, let us check whether it able to detect blobs or not. Okay, so I will go back to MATLAB, and here, so basically what we have to do, let us try to understand first. So we are getting our pattern, that is this particular Laplacian of Gaussian. We need to apply cross correlation with image, but we no need to do cross correlation. You may ask why, because cross correlation only what we require to find out where the pattern is matching in the bigger image, right? Yes, that is correct. But cross correlation and convolution will be same for this kind of Laplacian of Gaussian kernel. Okay. Now, why? Reason is very simple. What is the difference between cross correlation and convolution? They are almost same. Only thing is that in convolution, we do flipping, okay, of our kernel. But this particular Laplacian of Gaussian filter is symmetric. Okay. Here I can create one Laplacian of Gaussian filter for you. H equal to F special, okay, log filter, maybe 10 cross 10, 11 cross 11 size we want, okay, and sigma value let us take 2, okay, or maybe 1, okay. So this H filter looks like this. Now if you take flip, left to right, if you flip this matrix, and then also you will be getting same response. Let me show you. MS equal to flip LR of H. Okay. We will be getting MS some value. So let me now subtract MS from H and let us take sum of all the pixels. We should get 0. That's why, this will be MS actually. So that is flipped. Left to right flipped version of our kernel for LOG is same with our actual kernel of LOG. Okay, because Laplacian of Gaussian kernel is symmetric. So as this is symmetric, so cross correlation and convolution will be same. So what is expectation? Our expectation will be if we apply Laplacian of Gaussian filter on any image, such blobs should be selected. Okay. So what kind of blob we want? We want this kind of blob. Okay, that is where dark center is there at the middle, surrounding that bright pixel, surrounding that that is moderate brightness is present. Okay, so let us check that whether the Laplacian of Gaussian filter generated using MATLAB gives the same shape or not. Okay, because I have discussed two shapes, right? Here I have discussed two shapes, either this one or this one. Let us check which shape MATLAB gives. So here F special we have got. So here I can do figure and surf H to get the surface plot. Okay. So this is the surface plot. So this particular pattern is nothing but at the center it is going very low, that is dark pixel. Then suddenly it is taking hill kind of shape, that is surrounding that ring shape, bright pixels are there. Then it is making like flat surface, that is gray pixels are there. So that means nothing but this particular pattern only it is taking. So let us try to apply this LOG, that is this same filter, and let us try to visualize whether we can detect blobs or not. Okay. So for that, I have written this particular code. CLC clear all causal warning of reading cameraman.tif image, applying LOG filter and showing that. That's it. Okay. The code I have already shown earlier also. So we are basically applying I filter, right? Or blob filter, right? I have discussed just now. So we are getting this kind of pattern. Let me make here zoom, say OOM and hit enter. Okay. Now let me zoom a small part and show you what effect we can see after applying Laplacian of Gaussian. Okay. That is this particular part I am zooming, the face part only of the cameraman.tif, and here also the face part only. That's it. Okay. So see, here in the eye, if you observe, this particular eye part is what? See, dark, and then surrounding that, bright pixels are present. Okay. And as we are applying LOG, see what is happening in that eye part. If you observe, it is becoming brighter. Okay. See, eye part, let me zoom this particular part more. See, eye part, it is making brighter. Okay. Because pattern is matching. Okay, so this eye, this particular blob, dark blob surrounding light pixels is detected using our LOG or Laplacian of Gaussian. Okay, so I hope the concept of blob detection is clear to you. So this, using this eye filter, we have tried to highlight the eye part. So this particular eye filter is able to find the pattern of eye, where eye is present, because eye is also having same kind of pattern, right? So when you are doing cross correlation, here cross correlation is convolution only, right? Because this particular Laplacian of Gaussian filter is taking symmetric shape. So that's why I am applying here, but I am applying directly IM filter, that is conf 2 or conf 2D convolution, right? So the thing is that I hope the concept is clear to you, that why this particular filter can be used for blob detection. Similarly, reverse way, this particular filter is also present. Suppose you are getting such scenario where maybe one particular image is there where background is very dark, and in that image there are small red blood cells are present, okay, RBC. So that RBCs, if you want to find out, you just apply this pattern to find where this pattern is appearing, okay, and those RBC regions, red blood cells or red blood corpuscles regions, will be highlighted. Okay, that is also very important application of blob detection, right? So I hope intuitively you have got the feeling how the blob detection works. The complete code I'll be providing in the description box. If you want, you can go through that. Thank you for watching.